There are some very important tips to remember when using these indicators. First, before you start, gently rotate the stylus to make sure it's tight. As I mentioned before, the stylus or indicator tip coming loose is a common occurrence and should be the first thing you check if you suspect a bad reading from your indicator. Also, make sure your indicator stand, mag base, and indicator connections are tight. These are very precise, sensitive devices, especially the ones that measure down to 2 microns or 1/10,000th of an inch. You want to make sure your holding setup is rigid. Next, always approach the surface you're going to measure with caution and use the lowest jog increment if you're moving a machine axis. It's fine to come straight down on a surface, but try to avoid depressing the stylus to its maximum travel or beyond. Gently pick up the stylus until the needle reaches a good location where you can see it well. These indicators are sensitive to movement, and rotating the bezel while the stylus is touching something may cause the needle to bounce around or even change location of the needle. My tip for avoiding this when positioning the indicator by jogging machine axes is to rotate the bezel so the dial position I want to read is in clear sight before touching the stylus to the surface. Then I jog the machine to move the needle to the dial position I want. As I mentioned earlier, it's always a good idea to move the indicator off the surface you're measuring and then place it back on the surface to ensure you're getting repeatable readings. This brings us to another important tip. Always move the part from under the indicator toward the stylus tip, moving away from the body. The reason is, if your stylus is too low or the surface is too high, measurement from under the indicator body will safely lift the stylus or indicator. If you move the indicator onto the part from the side or from the front and your stylus is too low, you can damage the indicator. Always approach the part from above or underneath the indicator. When rotating cylindrical workpieces, always rotate so the surface comes from under the body, touches the tip, and continues rotating away from the body. We do this for the same reason. In case there's a keyway slot or other imperfection on the surface we're measuring that might damage the indicator.